what's funny about the preparation, Connie, I mean, it's just surprising. People think that preparing for a virtual meeting takes less time. It takes more time. If you're preparing correctly, it takes more time because you actually are thinking about the virtual details.
That's Michael Wilkinson, founder and managing director of Leadership Strategies, the number one facilitation training company in the U.S., and the accomplished author of several books on facilitation. He's all too familiar with the current scenario that many are now facing, how to best operate in this new remote work world. So what does it take to manage meetings effectively and still get to the outcome you need? Welcome to the Strategic Momentum Podcast, the show where we share tips, stories, and advice from progressive leaders on how to break through business and career inertia so you can better understand the business of work. I'm your host, Connie Steele. With COVID-19 rapidly changing the way we work, we felt it would be particularly relevant to share insights from a favorite past guest of ours, Michael Wilkinson. If you're like one of the many businesses now facing the reality of moving most operations online, it's possible that you'll find the adjustment to managing teams remotely challenging, either if you've never done it before or never on this broad of a scale. Michael preaches the tenets of process and preparation that enable leaders to boost collaboration, productivity, and morale among their teams. And in this episode, he'll review specific tips and advice on facilitating virtual meetings. Because our goal is always to help you navigate through the change we're all facing so you can create the right momentum to move forward.
More and more meetings are becoming virtual. We teach a class called Facilitating Virtual Meetings. And what is interesting is it's the same 10 principles. You prepare, you start, you focus, you do information gathering, you manage dysfunction. The principles are the same. And how you apply the strategies, though, are different. And let me just speak to a few differences. So we know when we're in a group face-to-face meeting, we need engagement every 20 to 30 minutes. Every 20 to 30 minutes, we plan an engaging activity. Well, when it's virtual, we cut that in half. It's every 10 to 15 minutes that you do that, where the issue with virtual courses, oftentimes you can't see the other person. And so they may be multitasking, doing all kinds of things. Oftentimes they can't see you don't have necessarily a place where people are seeing what's being written, what's being typed, or whatever that might be. And so first of all, we always recommend that if you're having a virtual meeting, the video is excellent because it allows better engagement. Even more important than the video, however, is for everyone to see the same screen in order for that as notes are being taken, it's almost like the flip chart thing where everyone can see what's being created because it creates focus. So it's pretty essential, even more than video, that people see what's being done because that allows better effectiveness, better focus as people are doing the work. A third technique that we use, even more so in virtual meetings, is the round robin. People have the misconception that, hey, if you call on people randomly, you'll get people paying attention more. It's just the opposite. It's when you systematically are every 10 to 15 minutes doing a round robin so that everybody knows they're going to have to respond, they pay much closer attention because it's happening every time. One thing we do for variety, we do change up the type of round robins we use. And we always change up the starting point. So that should change every time so that the people at the end, I did what that other person said and so on. And so that's a nice technique. And then the thing I wanted to,
So I would say that the preparation for a virtual meeting is incredibly crucial to know that people need to look at the same visual on the screen to ensure that all the folks who are participants in the meeting, particularly if you have potentially a larger size meeting versus a one-on-one, that all those folks have a voice and that they're engaged.
Very much so. And what's funny about the preparation, Connie, I mean, it's just surprising. People think that preparing for a virtual meeting takes less time.
I'm going to assume it takes more time.
Actually, it takes more time. If you're preparing correctly, it takes more time. because you actually are thinking about the virtual details. What are we going, how are we going to do this differently given that it's virtual? So you still have to do all the things you would do for a face-to-face meeting, but then you have to add the virtual details. What are you going to do because it's virtual? Another piece I wanted to mention, virtual, that people will find helpful. If there are generally more than 6 or 8 people in the meeting, you will certainly want to have a moderator, someone who's responsible for just the technical issues. If you imagine, if you're trying to start a meeting and one person's going, hey, I can't get in. And the meeting leader has to go off and deal with that person while everyone's waiting for the meeting to start. Having someone responsible for that. And I've facilitated some pretty interesting meetings. I'd say the most interesting on the virtual side. So you can imagine this. I had a client in the UK that we had done strategy work for, a 4-day strategy session, went over and did that. And we were ready to do the annual update. And it was going to be a 1-day session. And they called and said, hey, we'd love for you to come out on this date. And I shared with them, you know, I can do that. But if you think about it, you're going to have to pay a day for me to get out there. I'm going to be there with you. And you have to pay for a day for me to get back. You're going to, and then a day of preparation. You're going to pay for 4 days when I'm only going to be there one. Doesn't make a lot of sense. Why don't we go ahead and run that meeting virtually? And they said, oh, okay, we'll go ahead and do that. Connie, what was I thinking? The meeting started at 9 o'clock in the UK. That meant 4 o'clock a.m. Atlanta time. So here I was getting up at 3 o'clock for a 4 o'clock all day meeting. Yes, in my basement. But what we did, which was great. So everyone else was in the room, but me. I was the only virtual participant and I was the facilitator. And so we actually had a webcam in front of the room so I could see the whole room. And there were 24 execs at 4 tables. So there was a webcam at each of the tables so I could see the people at the table. And it was great. I'd make comments. I'd say, Tom, would you start flirting with Sarah over there? And let's stay focused. And people would laugh, right? Because they were just having a side conversation, if it were, because I could see the room. In the same way, when they did flip chart work, there were flip charts at every table. They would turn the cam toward that flip chart so I could see the flip chart and I could comment on what they were doing. At the end of it, the CEO said, no, Michael, when they said that the session was going to be virtual, I said, there's no way this is going to work. But oh my God, it was like you were in the room. And sure enough, it was like I was in the room. It can really work if you plan it and plan it well.
It may seem like running virtual meetings is easy to do. But in reality, running an effective meeting does take more strategy and preparation than an in-person one. I remember my own experience learning to manage a fully remote team 9 years ago. It was a complete adjustment. I really had to think about what I wanted to get out of each and every discussion so that not only could I guarantee the most salient points were covered, but more importantly, everyone had clear next steps so we could all move forward together. Because not only are you dealing with the technical environment, but you have to make sure that everyone is on the same page during the meeting. In these scenarios, your EQ is so important as it's critical to sense, feel, and react appropriately to how people are engaging with you in the meeting. So don't just focus on getting through it, but work to create that virtual connection. Thanks for listening to the Strategic Momentum Podcast. If you've liked what you heard or know anyone that could benefit from this advice, please share this podcast with others. For more great tips and insights on meeting facilitation, which applies to any environment, virtual or face-to-face, check out episode 45 with Michael Wilkinson. I'm Connie Steele, and you've been listening to the Strategic Momentum Podcast.